I may need a drink for this one. Pull yourself up a chair and let's talk about the ongoing cost for maintenance and support of a Magento site and why they're so dang expensive. When considering the cost, a lot of people look at what the platform itself costs and what it takes to build the site, and they make a decision. It's not until it's too late that they realize there's a lot more they need to be considering. Don't be so short-sighted. Think of your future.
Great Scott.
Open source software like Magento comes with a tax. It could be thousands of dollars per month to keep that train on the tracks and moving ahead at full steam. Depending on your business, the power and flexibility that comes with the platform may well be worth those costs. But that's not what this video is. I'm not trying to justify the costs, and this is definitely not knocking Magento. I'm just arming you with information so you know why these things cost what they do. At Jamerson, we do a lot of Magento support and maintenance work and have this conversation quite frequently. So it'd also be nice to just have a video to send folks to when they're wondering what these costs are, so might as well put it out there for everyone to see. If you're a Magento merchant dealing with these issues, be sure to let me know your thoughts in the comments. And if you need to discuss your maintenance needs, you can always go to jamerson.com/go, shoot me an email to set up some time to discuss it. Let's get into the reasons behind that Magento tax for maintenance and updates. Reason number one, numero uno, security patches come regularly and it's not like you can put them off. Magento, being open source and focused on e-commerce, is a prime target for those that would try to profit off exploiting it. Now, this is not a Magento-only problem, for sure. There was a SaaS platform that was hammered by an exploit a year or so ago that affected thousands of sites. And I won't mention which platform in public because they've already sent me a cease and desist for talking about their demise. And I don't like paying for lawyers.
Objection sustained.
We could totally be lawyers.
Bang.
Exploiting e-commerce sites is big business. There are teams of people out there that have it as their full-time job to try to find exploits on e-commerce platforms. Once they find something that works, it's pretty easy to automate it and attack a large number of sites. The difference with SaaS platforms and Magento is that it's your responsibility to fix and patch issues when they do occur. Now, Magento regularly releases patches to fix these issues to make it fairly easy on you. Glancing at their site, it looks like 8 patch releases in the last year alone. So you want to stay on top of those to make sure your site is secure. And don't just wait until the next version release comes out with all of these patches rolled into it. Reason number two, updates come regularly as well. Updates are a little different than patches, although they typically include patches in their release. Now, patches are usually small updates that really focus on security fixes. Updates, on the other hand, include new functionality. You can often hold off a bit on installing these if you need to, but they may contain bug fixes or some other functionality that's useful to your business. These updates can range from small releases that are simple to install to major releases that can take quite some time and potentially some rework of the custom portions of your site. Sometimes these updates actually have breaking changes. You can't just go in and run an update on a live site and just hope it all works. You can usually guess, though, how long it'll take by how much is included in the release, but you never really know how it will impact your particular blend of customizations. Everything on the site has to be well tested.
That was a test, and you've passed.
Over the last year, Magento has had about 5 or 6 small releases and 1 big release in Magento 2.4. And reason number three these things cost so much is that sites are usually custom with a lot of modules. SaaS platforms have the advantage of controlling their entire tech stack, and that makes it a little easier to build in stability. It's kind of like Apple. Although I know some people do it, Apple's operating system isn't really designed to just run on any hardware. It's designed to work on a limited, very curated set of hardware that they sell in their machines. And that gives them a lot of advantages in that they don't have to worry about all the other scenarios. With Magento, who knows where someone's trying to host this thing? I mean, it ranges from huge cloud infrastructures to pieced together servers stuffed in a closet. You then combine that with the platform's biggest strength, which is its flexibility, and you have a recipe for complexity. Almost no one takes Magento and just installs it as it is and does no modifications to it. If that's what you did, then you chose the wrong platform.
You want to go home and rethink your life.
I want to go home and rethink my life.
But you didn't do that. You added modules from third parties, had some custom ones written, and built something that's unique for your business. All that means that you're constantly going to be testing and adjusting the site for stability. Every change you make to the site has the potential to disrupt something that was previously working just fine. Every single patch, update, or additional module you add or modify could impact something else. It takes a consistent effort to ensure all that custom functionality stays on track. And reason number four are ongoing improvements. Magento usually attracts folks with complexity, big ambitions, or doing considerable volume. It's common, though, that the initial build is limited in scope to fit within a budget or a timeline. In this scenario, the build is often in phases, so they may be continually working to expand the functionality of the site or to add more robustness or automation to the features that were originally developed within the initial scope. It's pretty common for this to be lumped in with the ongoing cost of maintenance. The primary focus of the team is on these improvements, but their time is just diverted to maintenance and updates as needed to keep things up to date. So this can make those costs seem a bit more expensive than they really are because it's lumped in with other initiatives. And reason number five are that Magento developers are expensive, and you need more than one developer to maintain a site. Magento has moved upmarket from where it started over a decade ago, and Magento 2 is a complicated animal. There are a lot of big businesses with big budgets that are competing for the same limited pool of developer talent. And that puts Magento development talent in high demand, and it drives prices up. And you're going to need more than one of them. Front-end developers, back-end developers, DevOps, business analysts, Q&A, project management. It takes a team of experienced folks to manage a Magento site. You may not need all of them at one time, but you're going to need them. And add in the agency overhead, and the costs quickly add up.
Sounds expensive.
If you're looking to interact with a Magento partner agency for your ongoing support, then these arrangements are typically just structured as retainers. And that retainer will probably be tied to a certain number of hours, depending on how aggressive you want to be in continuing to improve your site. It may also have costs that include whatever non-technical services your agency of choice provides. If you're having trouble finding the right fit and need Magento maintenance, you might as well go to this URL and shoot me an email. I'm happy to discuss it anytime. If I missed something, let me know in the comments. It's always a pleasure talking to you, but it's time for me to get back to my bourbon. My name is TJ Campbell, and I'm the CEO and founder of Jamerson, where we help businesses like yours take those next steps in their e-commerce journey. If you're ready to improve your business and looking for help, go to jamerson.com/go, and I look forward to speaking with you. I appreciate you watching.